It's me, JD. So, a little birdie told me that Payday 3 is going to be released sometime between 2022 and 2023. And as a person who's played Payday 2 for a really long time, in fact, I'd consider myself an OG in Payday 2 because I've started playing when it came out in 2013, about 7 years ago, almost. I've been playing the game since the only contractors available were Hector, Elephant, and Bane. I was also there when the fastest way to level up was to speedrun rats on Overkill in under 10 minutes. I like to call this era of Payday 2 kind of the desync era. Because if you didn't have Xfinity's 1 gigabit internet speed, then whenever you join a lobby or play with your friends, they'd be lagging all over the map and bags would be thrown all over the map and enemies would be teleporting everywhere. Of course, they finally fixed the desync issue that Payday 2 had in 2017, so took about 4 years. So with the up-and-coming game, I just wanted to say five things Payday 3 should improve upon. So in no particular order, let's just start with number five, the weapons in the game, and the weapon variety and the weapon balance. Now, there's a lot of weapons in Payday 2. In fact, I think there are like hundreds of weapons in Payday 2, which on paper is a very good thing. It's cool to have a lot of different guns that you can choose from, but if we were to take a closer look at the guns, say like the assault rifles, they're around like maybe 50 of them, and when you really look at the stats of each weapon, you can see that there are really only three assault rifles based on like damage and mag size and ammo pickup. But the point I'm trying to make is that just some weapons are better than others. Right now, I'd say the strongest gun type or the build that you should have is based around LMGs. LMGs are kind of just really front-loaded assault rifles. Their stats, their base stats are really, really good for higher difficulties. And when you mod them, they become even better. On the other hand, we've got snipers. Now, snipers, in fact, I'm just gonna go out and say it, all the snipers are trash. They're just useless. No one uses them. And if you do use them, I'm sorry, but there are just better guns in general. So hopefully, Payday 3 will kind of fix these weapon issues and have a bit more variety in the stats of the weapons. I like to have more special weapons, probably more weapons based on fun, like the flamethrower and the Gatling gun, the miniguns and stuff. I wish those would be more focused on. And yes, they are in Payday 2, but they're not exactly the go-to builds of anything, and they're not exactly amazing. So I kind of want Payday 3 to expand on this whole weapon idea and make sure that these weapons like feel unique to themselves. Because honestly, you can pick up any old assault rifle and it feels just like the next one. Truthfully, that's what it is. On to number four, I want to talk about the enemies and special units that'll be in Payday 3. Now, obviously, I think they're going to include cloakers and bulldozers. I think those are like the iconic special units. I think bulldozers are a little bit too easy. When you imagine a bulldozer, you want it to be like this tank, like a tank in Left 4 Dead 2, right? It just rips through everything. It takes a whole team of you to take it down, and that's kind of what I want bulldozers to be like. But instead, in Payday 2, if you've played on the higher difficulties, they're kind of just like a beefed up version of a regular unit. Honestly, for the special units in Payday 3, I think they're going to reintroduce some of the older special units in Payday 2 into Payday 3. So like snipers, shields, and tasers, I expect to be in Payday 3. But I do have a problem with some of the other special units like medics. Now, in my opinion, medics are basically useless. I don't think they contribute anything to the game other than making it a little bit of an annoyance to kill something. Because if you're running like an LMG build, right, and you're shooting and you're emptying your round into this, or you're emptying your mag into this cop's head, and then the medic heals him up, I mean, then the very next blow will just kill him anyway. So medics themselves are not very great. But I would like to see the medic AI be kind of different. I like them to be like more focused on healing other special units rather than just being in a random group of fodder. So I'll just move on to the third point, which is skills and perks. Now, One of the best things about Payday 2, in my opinion, is the skills and perk system, and that concept is really cool, and I think they should definitely put that in Payday 3. So, with that being said, I will say that some skills and perks are just useless. They don't have, no one uses them, and they're basically trash. I don't even know why they're in the game. What skills I'm specifically talking about, well, sniper skills. The next skills that I have a problem with are kind of melee skills. Now, I know that it's kind of fun to go around hitting people with your melee, like smacking people upside the head with like dollar bills and stabbing them with the pen that you see from John Wick. But in all honesty, meleeing is pretty much useless unless you're using like a taser or the electric knuckles to stun a cloaker coming at you. A skill I would love to see in Payday 3 is a skill to maybe pick up more bags than one. Honestly, one of the most tedious things about Payday 2, especially when you're solo, is moving all the bags and loot that you've gained from the heist. Now, moving on to perk decks, just like skills, perk decks are kind of, there are certain perk decks that are less effective than other perk decks. Some perk decks are just flat out useless, and some perk decks are amazing. The Anarchist and the Stoic perk deck are the two best perk decks in the game to go loud with on higher difficulties because of just how tanky and the survivability they give you. There is one that's like the runt of the pack, and I'm talking about Crew Chief. Now, I don't know why this perk deck is in the game, but if you look at any of the bonuses it gives you, not only are the requirements kind of hard to satisfy with how the gameplay works in Payday 2, but the bonuses that it gives you and your crew is just worse than any other perk deck I've ever seen. You can use any other perk deck, I'd be totally fine, but don't ever use Crew Chief. It's disgusting. It belongs in the trash. Okay, so moving on to my second thing I would like to see in Payday 3 is more game modes. Yes, Payday 2 has been out for 7 years, and do you know how many game modes Payday 2 has? Well, I'll tell you. It has 2 game modes. Okay, you can fight me on this, but it has 2 game modes. It has co-op heists, and it's got holdout. Now, you could argue with me or debate me in the chat that Crime Spree and the Story Mode are game modes of Payday 2, but really, if you look at it at a base level, Crime Spree is basically just co-op heists. It's like a binging of co-op heists, like you do a lot of them in a row. And the story mode are just the heists, but like with a little bit of story description attached to underneath every heist. And that's basically what they are. I wish Payday 2 had more game modes. And one of them that I've been thinking about would be really amazing for Payday 2 is a versus game mode. Why is this not a thing? Why is this not a thing? Please. Please make this a thing in Payday 3. By versus mode, what I'm talking about is like, this game would kind of work like Left 4 Dead 2 versus, right? There's 4 heisters, there's 4 people who play specials, you know, you could be bulldozers, you could be tasers, you could be cloakers and stuff, and you just fight each other. So, all in all, put a versus mode in, please, and make the game so much more fun playing online, because everyone knows you hate to join in a stealth public lobby. Okay, those things never go well. It's just a couple more ideas for game modes. Even if you're gonna be like super lazy, you can at least put in something like weapon challenges, right? Like they have in Call of Duty, where you have like a weapon or something, and you have this dummy course that you run. You go through it, you shoot people, and you get like a score, and you can beat high scores of people and stuff, and you get rewarded for that. You know, the super easy stuff to put in, or at least super easy game modes to put in, I think. I would like to see a game mode something related to vehicles in Payday 3. There's a lot of potential in like driving cars or like flying helicopters. I wouldn't say put races in there, but you know, I'd say be like a getaway driver, and the game mode is that you're a getaway driver and you have to go and pick up these guys in a certain amount of time and get out, you know, stuff like that. And make the game easier to replay, you know, have a lot of replayability. My number one point is one that I've been that's or it's one that I've been that's been bothering me for a really long time, actually ever since the beginning of the game. Animations. And I'm touching a little bit on gameplay here, but more specifically, I want to talk about like the animation aspect of it. So in Payday 2, when you interact with something, nothing really happens. Okay, just like a circle, like I don't know, like a circle starts and then the circle finishes and you've done whatever you needed to do. I think it would add a lot of, or you make the game a lot more fun if, say, you know, when like Chain, like, okay, I want to see Chain's ass crack when he bends over to pick a lock. Okay, I want to see that animation. Okay, what I'm trying to get at is, if I'm picking a lock, I want to see my hands move up to the lock and start picking it. You know, when I'm hacking something, I want to see my hands come and press on the keypad. When I'm reviving someone, I want to bend over, have my hand down, like, dude, and like Chain's on the ground in a pickle. You know, he freaking takes my hand and I can pull him up. You know, when I'm picking up bags, I want to grab the bag. I want to see my character grab the bag and fling it over his shoulder. You know, stuff like that. I think small animations like that would make the game very nice to look at and very replayable in terms of a gameplay, because it just makes it so much nicer. You know, it'd be like, oh man, I really love the lock picking animation. I know it sounds a little bit picky, I guess you could say, because it's just like, oh, it's just a lock picking animation. But like, if you've been playing Payday 2 for like 7 years, you know, you kind of get tired of seeing that circle over and over again. In fact, I even think in my game I've modded it so that the circle is instead like a picture of like Rias from High School DxD, because I just hated seeing that interaction circle all the time. I want to see awesome reloads again. Now, I don't know why they changed this, but I can't find any gameplay of it. Does anyone actually remember when the interceptor pistol came out as like a community weapon? And the reload for that pistol was awesome. You'd like fling the pistol to the side and like a mag would like fly out, and then you'd put in like another mag, and that animation was amazing. I used that pistol solely because that animation was awesome. And I don't know when they patched it, but now the interceptor pistol just has like a regular reloading, or a regular pistol reload. Put in cool reload animations. That's awesome. I love stuff like that. I think that should be in Payday 3. I mean, hell, the minigun has like the worst reload animation because you don't even see it. It just goes off screen. By this point, I'm kind of ranting, and there's a lot more things I would like to talk about to put in Payday 3, but I think I'll save it for another video because this one's getting kind of long. If you like the video, then go ahead and like it. Also subscribe, and then you'll tell me that you want to see more stuff like this, and I'll definitely make some. So, yeah. Bye.